Good morning, students. I am Susmita Ananda, lecturer from Computer Science and Engineering. Today's our topic is website classifications. So first, we are going to know what do you mean by website. Okay? So, website is a collection of related web pages that may contain text, images, audio, and video files. The first page of a website is called home page. Each website has specific internet address, which is also known as URL, that stands for Uniform Resource Locator. That is, we need to enter in our browser to access a website. Website is hosted on one or more servers and can be accessed by visiting its homepage using a computer network. A website is managed by its owner, that can be an individual, company, or an organization. So basically, website is the collection of different web pages. Okay, so website is divided into two parts or two types. One is static, another one is dynamic. So static means constant and dynamic means it varies. Then is static. What do you mean by static website? So static website is the basic type of website that is easy to create. It is easy. It does not require the knowledge of web programming and database design to create a static website. Its web pages are coded in HTML, which stands for Hypertext Markup Language. The codes are fixed for each page, so the information contained in the page does not change and it looks like a printed page. So static website basically known as the constant. Another one is our dynamic, which is changing, which is varying to different times. So dynamic website is a collection of dynamic web pages whose content changes dynamically. It accesses content from a database or content management system. Therefore, when you alert or update the content of the database, the content of the website is also altered or updated. So this process is known as the dynamic. Okay? Dynamic website uses client-side scripting and server-side scripting. Okay? Or sometimes either client-side or server-side. Client-side scripting generates content at the client computer on the basis of user input. The web browser downloads the web page from the server and processes the code within the page to retain the information to the user. Let's see what is the basic difference between the static website and dynamic website. This is the most important part. So, in static website, content of web pages cannot be changed at runtime. But in dynamic website, content of web pages can be changed. In static website, no interaction with database possible. But in case of dynamic website, interaction with database is possible. In case of static website, it is faster to load as compared to dynamic website. But in case of dynamic website, it is slower than the static website. In case of static website, the development cost is cheaper. But in case of dynamic website, the development cost is higher or costly. In case of static website, no feature of content management. But in case of dynamic website, feature of content management system is available. In case of static website, HTML, CSS, JavaScript is used for developing the website. But in case of dynamic website, server-side languages or server-side scripting languages are used, like our PHP, Node.js, etc. Okay. In case of static website, same content is delivered every time the page is loaded because it is static, it is constant. But in case of dynamic website, content may change every time the page is loaded because this is the dynamic, this is not constant. It is changing as per the user requirement. So this is the basic idea and difference between the static website and dynamic website. Let's see, what is web portal? So web portal and website is little bit different. Okay, it is not same. So let's see, what do we mean by web portal? So a web portal is a specially designed website that often serves as the single point of access for information. It can also be considered a library of personalized and categorized content. A web portal helps in search, navigation, personalization, notification, and information integration, and often provides features like tax management, collaboration, and business intelligence and application integration. Okay. Web portals are also simply known as the portals. Okay. If we are not using web portal, it also refers to the portals. Okay. Web portals often provide a particular look and feel for organizations and enterprises, and also provide access control or procedures. Okay. So this is the basic idea of the web portal. Next is our social networking sites, which stands for SNS, social networking sites. So let's see, what is the social networking sites? A social networking site is an online platform that allows users to create a public profile and interact with other users on the website. Social networking sites usually have a new user input, a list of people with whom they are share a connection, and then allow the people on the list to confirm or deny the connection. After connections are established, the new user can search the networks of connections to make more connections. Okay. A social networking site is also known as social networking website or social website. Social networking sites have different rules for establishing connections, but they often allow users to view the connections of a confirmed connection and even suggest further connections based on a person's established network. A social media site has profiles and connections combined with the tools to easily share online content of all the types. For example, Facebook, Twitter, WhatsApp, Instagram, these are all about the social networking sites which we are using in our day-to-day life on the daily basis. Okay. Thank you.